Hi students, good morning. Welcome to CMS Digital Classes. I am Tufan. Today we will learn Unit 3 of Class 3 EVS. So this is all about the food story. We have studied EVS from our basic needs. First, we have learned about the clocks. Okay, then we have learned about our body parts. So first thing which we learn is body parts, sorry, and then we learn about our clothes, and now we will learn about the food story, means specially the food we eat. Okay, so in this chapter we will discuss several things about the food, why the foods are important for us, why we eat food, what are the sources of food, different types of sources of food, how we can eat food. I mean, some foods we eat by raw materials, or some food we use to cook and then eat. Okay, different utensils used for cooking food. Okay, and this type of all things related to the food we will learn, we will discuss in this chapter. Okay, next, first topic which we are going to learn is all about importance of food. Why food is so important for us? Sometimes this question asks like this, why we eat food. Okay, so these are the some reasons which we will discuss, why food is important, why we used to eat food. Okay, so first thing which we food is important is because we need food to live. If you don't eat any food, can we able to live? No, definitely. If we are talking about after oxygen, after breath we need is all about water and food. Water is also, we can consider that we are drinking, so that's a food only. Okay, this is of food only. So to live life, from for our living things, food is very important. Okay, without food we cannot live. Then for the growth of our body, food is very important. At the time of birth we are normally only very small in height, or weight also very light, 2 or 2.5 kilograms, like that. Okay, and we are very small at that time. So after then, after eating food, a lot of food, we grown up slowly. Okay, so that is why for the growth food is very important. If you don't eat food, you cannot live or you cannot grow also. Okay, as much if you are not taking a good amount of food, whatever the required for you, then your growth will be decreased. You cannot able to grow as per your requirement. I mean, whatever, suppose sometime you can see there are some people who are not grown, they become very small, or their age increase but their height not increase, or they become very thin. So they are not fit, you can say. Okay, so for the fitness of your body, you need to take the proper diet, you need to take the proper food, okay, as per the requirement. And next which we have is to be healthy. Yes, this is very important for us. Okay, because health is wealth. It is said that health is wealth. Okay, so sometimes we forget about the taking care of our health. Okay, due to the very busy schedule of our daily life, but this is very important. If we don't take a good quality of food, a proper amount of food, whatever the necessary for a particular person, then our health will not be fine. Our health will be decreased. There are several illness will come into our health. So to maintain the health is very essential. I mean, food is very essential to maintain the healthy life. So there are three most important reason to eat the food are: one is to live, another is to for your growth, and another is for your healthiness, to keep you healthy. So if it is asking why we need food, so we will answer like that: we need food because of our so that we can live, another so that we can so that we can grow, and another is so that we can be healthy. So we will answer like that. We need food to live, grow and healthy. This is the one word answer you can write. Otherwise point wise also you can write that for the living of our life, for the growth of our life and to become healthy, we need. These are the three basic reason to keep our healthy. So what happens in with the food is, when you eat the food, it gives us energy. So whatever the work you are doing, you can see, if you are not eating at a time also, in the morning, suppose you have not taken breakfast, or at the time of lunch you have not taken your lunch, then you will feel something weakness from inside you. Okay, if you not taken food for a whole day, you will not able to walk also properly. You will feel very weak because it you are not getting the proper amount of energy. So what happens whenever you eat food, in that particular food item there is some amount of energy. So that energy is very essential to do some work. Okay, so that is very important reason of eating food. So what food is giving to us? When we eat food, it gives us energy to do some specific type of work. Okay, now next reason is, it gives us nutrients which keeps us healthy. So nutrients is very important to maintain our health. If you are not taking a good food, then your nutrients will not be maintained properly and you will become ill. So for our good health, it is very necessary to take a good types of good quality of food. Okay, now it is required for, nutrients is required for to become healthy by protecting us from diseases. There are two kinds of blood cells which inside our body we have. One is red blood cell, another is white blood cell. Okay, so as you know that white blood cell protect us from the diseases outside. If any disease come inside our body, they used to fight with them. Okay, so that is the reason sometime if you feel ill, then fever comes and you feel very weak, because they give their best effort to fight with that particular whatever the germs or whatever the any enemy is coming inside your body. So that is very necessary. Nutrients is very necessary to fight with those diseases. Okay, to protect you from those illness. Okay, suppose some germs come, some for example you are taking you can take an examples of what we're going on now, that COVID-19 okay virus. So suppose any virus is attacking you, okay, so what your white blood cell will do is, they will fight with them. Okay, so if they own, then it will catch you, then you will feel ill. But if they fight with them and they are not allowed to enter them, then you will not be feel ill and you will be recovered. Okay, so that is why our food is very necessary, because from food we are getting nutrients, and that nutrients is very essential to maintain our healthness. Okay, to protecting us from the diseases. Those kinds of diseases will not be able to enter in our body. Okay, next piece we have is, it helps us to grow tall and strong. Okay, so as I discussed earlier also, some of the peoples you can see they are not growing as per their requirement, they become shorter. So if you want to become tall, then also you need a good food. Okay, and then if you want to become strong also, we need a good food. If you not take a proper amount of food, then you will not be so much strong. You will be very weak. Anyone will attack on you anytime. So if you take good amount of food, you can be very strong and no one can fight with you. Okay, so these are the some important reason of eating food, for taking food. Okay, so let's discuss about the next topic. So source of food. So we get food from both the sources. Okay, what are the two basic sources? One is plants, another is animals. If you you categorize all the food materials, you will find there are basically two category of food resources which we are getting. One, food resources are the resources through which we got our vegetable. Okay, vegetables and all, these are from plants. Okay, so the food items which we are getting from plants are the plant sources, and some food items which we are getting directly or indirectly from the animals. Okay, so those food items which we are getting from animals are called animals food resources. So two types of food resources are there, one is animals, another is plants. Okay, so here if you are talking about plant resources, we get fruits directly which we used to eat raw materials, as like those are some different kinds of fruits, as like apples, okay, bananas, okay, orange. So these are the all fruits which we are getting from plants. So these are also a food materials which are related to plant sources. Okay, next we are getting vegetables. Okay, so there are lots of vegetables which we are eating in our daily life. Those all we are getting from the plants. Okay, then cereals. So as like rice. Okay, so these rice, pulses, these all are the category of cereals. So we are getting these from plants only. Next which we have is pulse. Okay, and spices also. So there are several kinds of spices we use for cooking our vegetables. So those all are specially based, or we are getting from the plant resources. So basic thing to understand is there are two kinds of sources of food. One is the plant, another is the animal. Okay, so let's discuss about one-on-one about the plant resources, fruits, vegetables and plants, and pulses and spices. Okay, we discuss about the various kinds of why the food is important. Now see, every food items don't have all the capacities. Okay, so there are different kinds of food items which have some specific functions. Yes, there are some food items which include multiple functions, multiple things. But here, see, for example, suppose you are discussing now fruits and vegetables. So what the fruits and vegetables give us? Okay, so it gives us important nutrients. Whatever the nutrients which we need for our body. Okay, so those all nutrients we will get from the fruits and vegetables. That is why if sometimes you feel ill, then doctor suggests you to take the fruits and vegetables every day. If you want to maintain your healthiness, it is also instructed to take the fruits and vegetables every day, especially in the morning time. Okay, so what are the important nutrients it includes in our foods is, for example, fiber. So if you are eating fruits, then we will get a good amount of fiber. Okay, which is very essential for our body. So and vitamins also. So from fruits you will get fibers and vitamins. So fibers and vitamins both are very essential for our body, which we can get from the various kinds of fruits. Okay, so what the basic things these fiber and vitamins used to do is, it help us to fight the diseases. So that is, as I told, whenever you feel ill, that diseases used to, whatever the germs or whatever the virus, they used to fight with the your white blood cell. But our body also fight with them. And if you eat a good amount of good amount of fruits and vegetables, then they can fight in very good way. Okay, they can fight with the diseases. Okay, so it is very essential fruits and vegetables, so that our body, our health, our white blood cell can fight with the diseases. Diseases cannot able to enter to your body. So that is why first thing, the fruits and vegetables is most important. Okay, and it gives us fibers and vitamins. So these are the things which you need to keep in mind, that fruits and vegetables gives us vitamins and fibers. Okay, so fibers and vitamins you are getting from the vegetables and food. Okay, which is very important nutrients of our body, which help us to fight with the diseases. Okay, so what thing it help with? Yes, fight with the diseases. Next which we have is carrots. So which such as wheat, rice, and the maize. So these are especially seeds kinds of things. We use the seeds of the particular food. Okay, as like rice. Okay, pulse. So these all things are energy giving food. Okay, so these all food gives us energy to do work. Okay, so it is very essential if we are feeling very weak. So we should take the these kinds of carrots and wheat, rice. Okay, and maize. So to work, why the energy is essential? I already discussed that. To do some activity, to do some work, we need energy, so which is coming from the food. Okay, and what they also do is they also help us for the growth of our body. Without the good amount of carrots, your body will not be increased. If you only eat fruit, it is not able, you will not be able to survive. It is not possible to maintain your healthness without this. So it is also helping to your growth. So two basic thing it is doing. One, it is giving you energy. Another, it is helping you for your growth of the body. Okay, now next we have is pulses. As I told, there are some food items which have multiple benefits also. So here the pulses such as kidneys. Okay, and kidney beans and grams. So kidney beans, you can see that kidney beans are looking like the kidney, so that is why those are called kidney beans in English. Okay, so that is one kinds of pulses only. Okay, and grams are resources of protein. So through pulses we can get a lots of protein. Okay, so protein is a good resources of protein. The pulses are good resources for protein. Okay, and why protein is important is they help in the growth of our muscles of our body. So the muscles of our body, you can see these things, these all are the muscles of our body. So these are very necessary. This is giving you the proper shape of your body. If your muscles are not so strong or not proper muscles you don't have, then your body will not look smart. Okay, it will look very thin or it will look very dull. Okay, sometimes you can see these become very dark. So muscles means the these are which give you a proper shape of your body. So to maintain or to the growth of your muscles so that it increase. Okay, so that is very important. The pulse you have to take. Okay, so this is all about the sources, plant sources of the food. Okay, one more food item which we can get from the plants is the spices. Spices is very essential for the making of our vegetables and all. Okay, without spices it will not become so tasty. Okay, so that is spices is also very important source of food which is we are getting from the plants. Okay, so such as cinnamon, okay, pepper and cardamom. So these are the some important food items which we are getting from the plants. Okay, so what it is used for, it gives the flavor to our body. Okay, there are some spices also which gives our several kinds of whatever the body requirement we have nutrients. Okay, but normally very less amount of nutrients we are getting from the spices. Okay, so this is specially we use for the flavor of the food items, whatever we are preparing, whatever we are eating. It increases the taste of the food items. Now there are some leaves also which we use for the food of our, okay, which we are getting from the animals. Not even leaves only, there are some flower also which we used to eat for our nutrients, okay, so which we are getting from the plants. So this is how we are getting, there is lots of things, there are several food items from the plants, especially the maximum food items we used to get from the plants only, okay, and the rest of all we used to get from the animals. So in next class, in next video, we will learn about the food items which we are getting, we used to get from the plants, okay. So that's all about the food resources which we are getting from the animals, so animals food resources, okay. So these two question is your homework. Question number one is why food is important, and question number two is what are the sources of food. As we discuss two kinds of sources of food, so that two kinds of sources of food you have to write, and then write about some plant sources. So you have to write something about some plants sources of food, okay. So pause the video, write to these two homework, okay, and do properly. The homework should be at least 2 pages, okay. So question number 2 is long question, so write accordingly. Thank you, have a nice time, take care.